Hey, I'm Nicholas, and this is a how-to-play of my latest game, CatheDraw, a roll-and-write game about building the most impressive cathedral ever. To start with, you need the player sheet, 6 dice, a pen, and the reference sheet, from where you also need to cut out the 10 master cards. Start by shuffling the master cards and flip over 3 cards to the right of the stack. Now you're ready to play. Each turn begins by passing time. This is simply done by crossing a diagonal line in your construction grid. Notice that the grid are divided into 3 sections. There are 2 types of master cards, plans and craftsmen. Remove any architect plans from the right of the stack to the left, where they will remain. Architect plans can be bought at any time and will score in the end if completed. Craftsman cards can be bought by paying the price indicated in the bottom and can be used for the duration of the game. Move it down below the stack to indicate that you bought it. Start by rolling for resources. You take the number of dice equal to the number of small churches in your parish. The dice pip represent different values listed here, where ones are gold. You can at any time buy any resource for the amount of gold shown here, the most expensive being glass that costs 3 gold. After you roll the dice, you may choose to reroll some or all of the dice once. When you are done with the reroll, you are ready to construct. You don't have to use gold when you roll it. You can draw a circle for each gold rolled in your church bank. Then you look at the building chart to see what you can build. The build chart is divided into 4 types of elements. These must be constructed on the ground plane. These can be built anywhere. These are not allowed in the bottom 2 rows. And lastly, you cannot build anything on top of these. There are also a few rules to follow when building. Pay the cost. Build on top of ground or another element in a free space. Cross out time used. So if the element has 2 sun and moon symbols, you cross out 2 squares. But you may pay 1 gold from your bank to avoid passing any time for that element. When you build scaffolds, you are allowed later to build inside and or on top of it. But it will score negative if you do not build on both spaces inside. You can save dice in the free spaces of the laborer house. If you need more space, just pay a wood to open a new house. Anytime during your turn, you can pay gold, wood and time to draw an extra church in one of your empty parishes. This will add a dice to your next resource roll. You may also cross out any number of churches to collect 4 gold each time. This does not affect the number of dice you roll in your turn. Remember to start each turn by passing time by crossing out 1 space on your grid. Afterwards, rearrange architect plans to the left and then draw until there are 3 visible master cards to the right of the stack before you roll for resources. This was the basics. Now continue until you got the cathedral for the bishop. The game ends when you're out of space and the grid. For scoring, you can use the wheel on the player 8. Start with points from column heights by the black line and then go clockwise. Remember that architect plans and master craftsmen can add to the final score. I hope you enjoyed the game. Feel free to share a picture of your construction with the hashtag CatheDraw so we can marvel at your construction.